Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Deadly, Book 6, Pluck, written by Paul Jennings and Morris Gleitzman, and read by Francis Greenslade and Melissa Eccleston. Be sure to visit our website at www.belinda.com. Details of other available and forthcoming Belinda audiobook releases can be found at the end of this recording. Sprocket, Chapter 1. I stopped dead, paralysed with shock. So did the ageing Brats, Beanie, Scowler and the Reptile. I was their prisoner, but for the moment they weren't interested in me. The sight of the snowboard rider standing there in the high valley had frozen them in their tracks. Their brother, the evil pooper scooper, let out a strangled cry. It echoed down the slope to where my friends Conrod, Purple Cloud, Amy and Mrs. Tunks Livingstone were struggling towards us, coming to save me from certain death. Behind them came the rest of the crazed family, pulling some sort of snow-covered box behind them. But now I stared in amazement at the snowboard rider as she took off her goggles. She was at least 100 years old. Wrinkles ran like crazy rivers in every direction across her face. Her bright white hair was cut very short in a trendy fashion. Her eyes sparkled as she gazed at us. The four old brats looked as if they had seen a ghost. They all yelled out the same word at the same time. Mother! At the sound of that word, a feverish heat swept through my body. My legs began to tremble. I felt as if my burning feet would melt the snow and send me sinking from view. I tried to speak, but no words would come. Their mother was... my mother. My dream had come true. Dream? Was the whole thing a dream? Like a sleeper trying not to wake up, I tried to keep the vision of this woman alive. I clung to her image, not wanting it to vanish. But she began to shimmer and fade as a million questions swarmed around in my tortured brain. Had I really swallowed a seed that could give eternal youth? Was it even now germinating inside my swollen stomach? Were these aging warriors really my brothers and sisters? As if from a long distance, I peered at Reptile's wrinkled mouth and thinning hair, and Beanie's grey beard, and Scowler's angry red-lined eyes. Had they really gone from 6 to 60 in 3 days? Was there really a girl called Amy, whose mother had turned into a baby? Was Purple Cloud a middle-aged dream hippie or a real person? A vision of Conrod and his weird mobile home drifted into my mind, only to be replaced by a picture of me and Amy fleeing from hostile nudists, floating down the river on the frozen corpse of my father. The Germinator had been this dream woman's husband. The man in the ice block was my dad. It was a dream. It couldn't be true. Loud voices rang in my head, but the words had no meaning. I was unable to speak or listen. The figures in the snow around me gestured and jumped like living shadows. Then they began to fade. I blinked my eyes and tried to call them back. I didn't want to wake and find myself in the bedroom of a lonely foster home. I wanted my dream mother. A hand fell on my shoulder. A real hand. I struggled to bring its owner into focus. It was one of the brats. His words bored into my brain. He claims he's Randall, said Beanie. The wonderful old lady was staring deep into my eyes. She was not a character in a dream. She was a dream come true. Her lips trembled. A tear ran down her cheek. She was unable to speak. Words were not sufficient. She held out her arms. Randall, she choked. My son. Every nerve in my body seemed to fire at once. A wave of joy and happiness like I had never known before lifted me up and carried me forward. "Mum!" I cried. "Oh, Mum!" I rushed into her embrace. My search was over. She pulled my wet cheek against hers and held me tight. We just stood there, hugging in silence. The cold chill of loneliness that had made my bones ache since before I could remember seeped away into the snow. My mother's arms were like the walls of a solid house, like the keel of an unsinkable boat, like the blankets on a soft bed. For the first time in my life, I felt safe and loved. My mother's arms were a mother's arms. There was no other place to be. We stood there hugging each other for minutes, for an hour, I couldn't say. But it wasn't long enough. Finally, we pulled apart. My mother's happy smile suddenly faded. She stared at my swollen stomach. "Oh, no," she said in a shocked voice. "Randall, you haven't." "Yes, he has," said Beanie. "He swallowed a seed." We were surrounded, not just by the Brats, but by my whole new family. The older ones had caught up with us, the tea lady and hairy chest, the two I called Lobster Bottom and Jimi Hendrix, and all the rest of my ageing brothers and sisters. They had made their way up to our mountain valley. And my friends were there as well, Amy and her mum, Mrs. Tunks Livingstone, Conrod, Purple Cloud, and dear old Matchbox too. Amy and her mum were smiling. "You found your mum at last," said Amy. "Your journey is over." I was too filled with joy to remember that Amy was on her own journey, to find her father if he was still alive, and to reunite him with her mother. Mrs. Tunks Livingstone was now at least 25 years old and growing older by the minute. She winked at me, and I fleetingly wondered if she was recalling our kisses in the dark guards van last night when she'd been a teenager. Purple Cloud had watery eyes. She gave a little sniff. I wanted to give her a hug too, but this wasn't the time. I knew that she was happy for me, and sad for herself because I didn't need her for a mother. I had found my real mum. My mum beamed around, staring in happy amazement at each of her children. She didn't seem to mind that they had all grown old. "I hoped it was you, children," she said quietly. "You've come to your senses at last. You've given up the tea and let yourselves grow old gracefully." She ran to Beanie and peered into his eyes. Then she hugged him. "I'd know you anywhere, Barnabas." Beanie hugged her back with tears in his eyes. "Mother," he said, "look at you. You're... He couldn't seem to bring himself to say the word. "Old," she said. "Yes, I'm old. And what's wrong with that?" "Everything," said Beanie. He held up the label from the skin cream jar. "In only a few years you've gone from beautiful to..." He couldn't bring himself to finish the sentence. Mother moved among her elderly children, dragging me with her. She didn't want to let go of my hand. She went to each one in turn, giving them a hug and a kindly comment. "Stanley, you look good without hair. Hilda, are you still driving fast cars?" Then she turned to the melting man. "Silas, you look miserable. Come on, cheer up." She even had a friendly word for the tea lady and hairy chest. "You seem to have looked after the others well, Agnes and Hubert," she said. There was a lot of mumbling and grumbling when she made that comment, especially from the Brats. "They made us into 6-year-olds. That's not looking after us," yelled Scowler. "You were always hard to control, Stanley," said my mother. Finally, she came to the last of her children. "Orson," she said slowly, "you told us that my baby died in the river. You were the only other one there." You dumped your own brother.
So what? Hissed Pooper Scooper. You were going to pass the secret of the seed onto him instead of me.
Reptile was angry with her brother.
Orson, you told us he drowned in the river with father, she yelled. You lied!
You shouldn't have done it, said Beanie. You can't abandon your own kin, said Lobster Bottom. That was unforgivable.
So was nicking off with the train,
added Jimi Hendrix. The others were all staring at me in a different way now. I wasn't the intruder anymore. I was their brother. But they were shocked out of their brains.
Orson, my mother said, you have a lot to answer for.
Rubbish, snorted Pooper Scooper. You're old and decrepit. You're going to die of old age. So are we if we don't get more tea. We haven't come here to grow old like you. We came to see if there were any more tea plants up here in the mountains. We want to be young again. We're not going to die. Not like Gramps. Not like you.
My mother smiled at him sadly. Life is a circle, she said. We must return from where we started. Everyone has to make the whole journey. No one can stay young forever. Pooper Scooper grew redder and redder in the face. He spat viciously into the snow.
Bulldust! He shouted. Old is ugly! Old is painful! Old is senseless!
I stared at them both.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.